We have a big squid. And Al Sabatka is stirring up the crowd.
He's going to bring that to his barbecue later on, too.
It's slippery, Al. He is in charge of the ice here and reported the temperature on the surface today at 5 degrees.
Not too many options left for the old octopus to find its way on the ice. Only three more games here for this to happen.
It took a while tonight, didn't
it? Yeah,
it
did. I'm surprised. Would have thought there would have been one earlier.
Well, Sobotka out to retrieve it and give it a twirl as he so often has.
The Rangers and the Islanders coming into tonight. You know, they play against each other. The Islanders have an extra game. It's interesting.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, from a Bruins perspective, it'd be good if the Rangers were pretty mad. Did somebody throw an octopus on the ice? Detroit does travel well.
To have a shift like that and have a game the way they've played, and, you know, and not to overlook something too, Jack, as we really enjoy the complete game effort right now as we get some more squid on the ice.
Calamari, baby.
A guy like Max Talbot.
Yeah.
You know, he comes up and okay, it's an emergency. You know, you got to have injury for him to be in the lineup. But the fact that he went down with the right attitude in Providence, a guy that's played in big game situations, a veteran guy, you know, he didn't go down to Providence and get out of shape. He kept himself in great shape, worked hard. His numbers were good down there. Even though he's not a guy that goes down there and is going to put up 100 points in the American League, it's not his game. You know, he's one of those gritty guys and a role-playing guy no matter what league he's in.
All night long, it wasn't pretty at some points throughout the game because there were some defensive lapses that cost a couple goals, but they stuck with the game plan. I think Curtis Lazar's having a little post-game snack right now. Hope there's not a weigh-in tomorrow morning.
I think it's conclusive, Doc. They've got to go with the call on the ice, which is no goal.
So we play on with a minute 46 to go in OT.
Oh, the smoke bomb.
Is that what it was?
Yeah.
Okay, I saw something hurled out of the seats, and it had a light at the end of it, but I didn't realize that's what it was.
Oh, yeah, right. I saw that flash through as well. Thought it was a falling star, and then I realized this isn't an outdoor game.
I should remember from my Halloween days, but I had forgotten clearly.
Oh, what a save by Marty Brodeur, though, to get the rib of his pad on the puck. And it looks like there's going to be a slight delay. It might also be a stink bomb as well as a smoke bomb. All the players are out on the ice milling around. Now, why would that be? They're looking, you know, Doc, it was right down below us that I saw the smoke bomb or being thrown. So they're trying to locate the crazy individual who just did that. We may have a replay. Watch here. We've got a replay. Watch in the goal area here. It's going to come flying. Let's keep watching. Same area. Oh, there's the smoke. There's the smoke after it landed. But I saw, as you did, Doc, I saw it traveling through the air, and it had a flame behind it. And I couldn't figure out at the time what it was. And now we know. But, I don't know. You ever seen that before?
That's a new one. Chirping at players.
Well, a Nashville fan has thrown a catfish on the ice. And the linesman, Scott Driscoll, won't touch it.
He looked over, and I think he did that for her. This is the moment, and this young lady grabs it. She's got the stage all by herself right here. Yeah.
Now they're
really low. Oh my, there's always time to retrieve a catfish. Fresh from the Cumberland River, Pete.
Yes.
So Brian Murphy, $14.95 in a good restaurant. You know that, eh?
Yeah, Brian. Well, more than that in a good restaurant. Brian Murphy takes it off, and there's John Holmes with the bucket, ready for the catfish.
The Predator fan snuck in a catfish here, Doc, and
The local fish markets did go on television yesterday and said they check very carefully such things as phone numbers and credit card zip codes and things like that before they were going to sell a catfish. Locally here, it has
no cash for catfish, or
no,
what?
It you just had to you had to be interested in eating it conventionally at home over this holiday weekend, or they weren't going to sell it to you. But the best laid plans.
The two best scoring chances for Nashville here in the third period.
Uh-oh, Thrasher jerseys being thrown onto the ice. Look at that.
What is that?
Thrasher's jerseys thrown on the ice.
I have no idea what that is.
Is that in tribute to their old team, or?
I hope it is. I hope we take it as a compliment, because haven't played the game for a lot of years. But one thing you don't allow is disrespect to your jersey, man. That's Pat Quinn when they were running over his jersey, and he went ballistic when he was a coach.
Yeah.
How could you not love a guy like that? And now someone's thrown a Leaf sweater on the ice in play. And Rene hangs on to the loose puck.
Yeah, that guy's an idiot, though, because to do it during the play, somebody could easily get hurt. The security's chasing him out. I hope they grab him up in the concourse.
Bounce away from Clarkson, still loose in front, and Ponick couldn't get a stick on that. And now the puck skips over the glass, and with 1:39 to go in the second, we've got a sweater tossed on the ice. And the individual who did it quickly exited the building. Collided with him at the point. Gardner takes a shot. There's another sweater on the ice in the Toronto end. That's two tonight.
I got it.
Here's Santarelli. And referee Greg Kimmerly picks up the sweater and flips it quickly during play into the penalty box. There's another one. It's raining Leaf sweaters. There's another one down in their zone. Good heavens.
I'd say there's a, you know, you can protest however you want and boo however you want. It's a potential for somebody to get hurt.
Shen battles it past Stapleton. The Leafs get it up on the wing. Kessel ran into Hainsey, but is able to get to the loose puck. Now carries in over the line, and Hainsey reached around him, and it is shot in wide of the goal, and
waffles.
And some fan has decided to throw something on the ice, and it'll be scooped up.
An idiot, and he's being ushered out of here. And that was right in mid-play.
Somebody could have slipped on that.
Yeah. The waffles are on the ice again, whatever that means.
I haven't figured that out either. But and fan being escorted out. And the faceoff to the left of Pavlik.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, hold those wristbands in your hands, show some class here. This is Philly. This is not somewhere else in the NHL. So hold them, put them on your wrist, and supposedly do not put them on the ice. Have some class.
No!
It's Henrik Sedin off the ice, and someone has thrown a fish on the ice.
Here his opportunity, not for that fish. Second best power play at home, almost 24%. This is where you've got.
And a lot of variation. Sagan with speed this time, in on Hedberg, closes and scores!
Even despite the debris thrown onto the ice when Sagan was charging towards Hedberg,
which is inexcusable.
I think the Devils are going to try to bring attention to it.
Yeah, why not? Why not?
But as far as the move by Sagan, attack with speed, come from the off-wing side, move backhand to forehand, get the goaltender moving, Hedberg tries to take away the lower half of the net, which he did. Sagan wisely goes up top.
Palmieri trying to fight through the traffic.
Oh, big collision there with Ekblad. Here comes Huberdeau moving in. Huberdeau makes a move, and he scores! What a goal by Jonathan Huberdeau! And on Rat Night at the BB&T Center, the Rats come raining down on the ice.
Well, you want this number one line to get going. Well, Huberdeau, he has points in three games. That was three goals, one assist. Now he has points in four games, and that's four goals and one assist, and he's only getting started. I'll tell you what, he put a move that just basically eliminated three of the Devils, including the most important guy, number one, Kincaid. Take a look at that. Kincaid just doesn't have that length. He's 6'3". But not enough. And I'll tell you what, this is not very good, folks. But moving on, this could be a penalty for the Florida Panthers hockey team. You can't throw rats on the ice now.
I don't mean to laugh, but yeah. Boy, does this bring back a lot of memories. Yeah. They're commemorating the team in 96 that made the Stanley Cup final, and they gave out rats tonight. And, you know, they have a writing on them saying 95, 96 Panthers. Yeah. So I was thinking maybe they wouldn't get thrown because everybody would want to keep them. And here's the first goal of the game. And boy, I feel like we're back in the old Miami Arena, Denny, 20 years ago.
I know. The big board has a big sign. Please refrain from throwing objects on the ice. I find it interesting that they're not saying rats, because you will be ejected, and it may just happen. Of course, it's within the rules now. Florida Panthers could get a penalty for this.
Is it ahead? Brought back on, but not yet controlled by Shepard. Over to Straka, to Shepard, and Straka!
This is the Avalanche's first look at the Rats. My goodness.
Well, this is the heaviest.
Oh.
They added more staff for this game tonight. 25 people are out there gathering them in. The strangest thing they said they've picked up in these playoffs, it's been a box of Decon, which is a rat killer. They actually did have, as you will have with any spontaneous thing, somebody who actually turned loose a real one out there, and they very carefully got it coaxed into one of the buckets that they use.
And the Panthers are going to win this game as he gets in and scores as time expires. And the Rats come raining down here at the Bank Atlantic Center in Sunrise.
Wow! Shades of 96.
The Panthers have tied this series up one game apiece on their home ice, their first playoff win since April 17, 1997 at Miami Arena. Not in this building. And they celebrate with Jose Theodore with 23 saves on the night, his first playoff win since 2008. And the Panthers salute the home crowd as they sweep away some plastic rats, which date back to that memorable run in 96 from the old Miami Arena, which had its share of rats.
Person throws a live chicken on the ice during a hockey game. Craig Rodenfels found it a pretty funny thing to do.
Here on the ice to clean up.
Is that a phone?
Somebody not enough of their phones. Is that one of your phones, Dave?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is, actually.
You have like three or four, I mean.
Well, I'm trying to think of a mindset.
I don't know if I've seen the
what
phone.
You would do to throw a phone on the ice.